Titles and transitions within Final Cut Pro are really important features that you probably will need and just want to use over time. So let's stay true to the title of this video and transition over to talking now about titles and transitions. We'll use these two clips as examples.
There's one of my drone. This is a pretty cool looking shot, and then this absolutely gorgeous shot that the drone filmed that day. It was just super pretty. So if we wanted to add some transitions or titles, let's explain how to do that, starting with titles. You can go up here to the titles menu, and then that's, you know, where all of your titles are. All of the titles work basically the same, but there are a few important things to keep in mind. Any of them that say 360 are, believe it or not, for 360 cameras. So that means if you're not doing a 360 video, weird things could potentially happen with your title, mainly in terms of how it's going to be positioned around the frame. Sometimes it's okay, sometimes it's weird. If you're not doing 360, I definitely recommend not using a 360 title. So if you scroll down a little bit, that's where you will get all of the other regular titles that you can choose from. Some of them are cheesy, might be the word. So I would probably use a light touch when it comes to using some of the default transitions and things. Plus, more importantly, because when you use something like this one right here, other people are going to be using this exact same template, and that means your project is going to look a lot like other people's project. So anything you can do to help yours either stand out or just not look like everybody else's is really important. But there is some really cool stuff in here, and essentially, no matter which title, how cheesy or uncheesy it is, when you add it to your timeline, it will show up as a purple bar. You can then adjust it. When you click on it, you can go over then to the inspector, and now you have the ability to change the title through this text menu, and then you also have some specific features for that exact title or template. Personally, if I ever use a title, the one I prefer is the basic title. It's the simplest, it's the easiest, it's basically just words on the screen, it's super simple. So if we wanted to take this basic title and add it to the shot of the drone over here, maybe I could make it extend out to the exact same length. You'll notice right here, the title is in the middle of the screen. I can click and drag it and move it around, or you can use the inspector and move it around the same way that you would anything else. If I want to change what the title says, I can go over here and go like, this is a title. That's not how you spell title, that's title. Title. There it is. From here, you can change the size. You can also go over to the transform tool and adjust things that way if you want to. We can adjust line spacing. So if I had a second line, now I can adjust how much space there is between these titles. I can adjust character tracking. So you do have a lot of flexibility. Of course, you have all of the fonts on your computer. Simple fonts, things like Helvetica, Futura, Georgia, those are classics for a reason, honestly. And they might be ones to consider if you don't know where to begin, because fonts and lettering do communicate things. You can take your, you know, Helvetica, make it really bold, play with the tracking a little bit to make it look a specific way. Maybe even want bold italic. And now we can have this title here, which actually looks pretty awesome. Now, if we wanted to change the color or some of the other features of this title, you can scroll down and there are a few other options, including things like adding a drop shadow or adding a glow. And with every one of these effects, you can click show and it's gonna give you more and more options to adjust. So if we wanted to add our drop shadow to make the title a little more visible, this is how we could do that. And now you can click those on and off just like anything else we can see without the drop shadow, with the drop shadow. It definitely helps quite a bit. If you want to change the color, you just need to go up here into face, and that's where you can then adjust the color to be whatever you might want it to be. One thing I like to do with titles sometimes is if a drop shadow isn't working or just maybe sometimes doesn't look the way that I want it to look, what I'll do to make the title stand out is I'll add in a generator under it. So I'll take a generator, add it down here, and then I will change the opacity of that generator to 75%. But instead of just covering up the whole screen, I will go to the transform tool and then make that a little bit smaller. And now I can bring that kind of right here. Sometimes I even put it at an angle, sort of like that. So this can sometimes be a cool way to add a background to something. If these are light letters on a light background and they're blending in, this can help a lot. And of course, you can go into your generator and change the color if you wanted it to be a different color. We could have it be, you know, any color we want. We can also change the blend mode. Overlay is usually a fun one that kind of just blends things in a little differently. It sort of takes the colors that are behind that layer and blends them in a more interesting way than without them. So this is with overlay. If I go back to normal, this is what a normal blend mode looks like. So those are the basics of our titles. And again, if you're using something that has some kind of animation in it, when you click on this little T over here, this is where you're gonna have all the settings to adjust the specifics for that template. But we're using a basic title right now, so it doesn't have anything like that. Now let's talk about transition. Let's transition over to transitions. I'm gonna move this over here. Transitions are over here in this side menu. An important thing, just like with titles, transitions can easily get really, really cheesy. You just drag them over to two clips that you want to create a transition for. Sometimes, depending on the clips that you're adding transitions to, Final Cut might give you this warning. You can usually just click Create Transition and it will show up. But this transition right here, for example, it's a little cheesy. It's a little cheesy. So be careful with your transitions. Important to remember that this right here, what we have, this is the most common and often the most effective transition there is, which is just a hard cut. Going directly from one shot to another in a single frame, that is the most classic, probably the simplest transition. Sometimes you might want to do something like add in a whole bunch of cross dissolves because they look really pretty and they make your footage blend in a really nice way. And those can look really nice, but I think it's important to remember that transitions do communicate something. And so something like a cross dissolve, for example, and a lot of transitions really do communicate the passage of time. And so if you create a project where there's a bunch of cross dissolves in it, even though it might look nice, what you're subconsciously or even sometimes super consciously communicating to your audience is that time has passed, which might not be what you actually want to communicate to them. Sometimes when you first get Final Cut Pro, it's easy to go to the transitions and just think there's so many cool things you want to add to all your videos, but it can very easily become distracting. So as is the case with pretty much any kind of effect, I think it's always best to use a very light touch. Now, as you might have just seen, if I added this clothesline transition and I decided that's a little cheesy and I don't want that transition, all I have to do is click on the transition and press delete and it will go away. But let's say we did want to use a cross dissolve. Maybe here I'm talking about this drone and then I'm going to say something like later that day I took the drone out for a flight. That would make sense then to have a cross dissolve where I could go later that day I took the drone out for a flight. Time has passed, the cross dissolve makes sense. So this is a good transition to use right here. Right now, this is just the default transition, but if we wanted to adjust the speed, we can click on the edges and then drag them in or out to adjust the length of the transition. You can also use the period and comma keys to do that, just like when you're editing a regular video clip. On the transition itself, these little lines that are on each end, these will let you trim from that edge. So now we're trimming into the clip on the left, and now we're trimming into the clip on the right. So if you need to kind of tighten things up a little bit, and the middle arrows here will let you move the actual transition point. So you do have a lot of options to continue adjusting the transition after you've added it to your timeline. Now going back to the power of titles and transitions, let's go over here again to the one that we made before. And instead of just having this pop up on screen, let's add a transition to this title to almost make like a little effects package. Because you can also add transitions to titles, generators, basically any layer you can add a transition to. So let's start by deactivating the title and just focusing on the background layer. I'm gonna go into the wipe, and I love using just a regular classic wipe for something like this. Sometimes when you add a transition, it's going to put them at the beginning and the end. I don't want this one at the end, so I'll delete that. And now this generator will wipe in, which looks really cool. It's going in the right direction, which is great. If I didn't want this to go left to right, I could go up to the inspector and then change the angle, change some of the edge treatment. You have a lot of options to fine tune your transitions for most of them. And of course, I can also change the duration as well, but this looks pretty great. And then the next thing I could do here is reactivate the basic title. Let's go back over to our dissolves and add a cross dissolve. I don't want these to come on at the exact same time. I would love for this back layer to roll out first and then have the title show up. So that means I will move this over to kind of the middle of this transition point, see how that looks. Hey, that's pretty good. So now with just a simple title, a simple generator, and some simple transitions, we have this really cool little effects package that's gonna show up and make things pretty interesting in our video. And before we wrap this up, right here, you notice I'm just adding this transition to this one layer. It's transitioning from black, basically. Sometimes you might wanna do that, and what you'll find is you'll say, hey, I want this DJI thing to fade in. You'll add in the cross dissolve, but it forces you to then put these two clips together. This happens a lot if you have clips on top of other clips. And if you don't want that to happen, just make sure there's some separation between your clips, add your transition the way you want it, and then you can move your clips together and the transition will only affect one clip and not the other. So as you can see, there's a ton of creative options you have with transitions and titles within Final Cut Pro, and I hope this gives you a basic understanding of some of the essentials. Thank you so much to everyone who helps support my channel through Patreon and YouTube channel memberships. And if you like this video, check out my video editing course, Rough Cut to Final Cut, where I share literally everything I know about editing in Final Cut Pro.